today, I'm going to show you how I like to cook these Boston butts for some good pulled pork here at the house. Now, I'm going to be rolling with a hot and fast method. I'll be cooking on my stick burner and running pecan. Now for this, I'm going to trim off some of the pieces of meat that's just hanging that might burn during the cook. And I'm going to open up this money muscle just a little bit so we can get just a tad more flavor in it. Now, if you don't want to trim, that's fine. It's just a habit I got into years ago. So once we get her trimmed up, we're going to flip her over. We're not even going to worry about the fat cap. It's not hurting nothing. So all that's left to do, give that baby a spank. Let's get to working. So I've got two butts. I'm going to do a little taste test for my kids. So I looked around here at the house, see what I had for an injection. So we've always got Dr. Pepper. That's going to add some sweet. Then we're going to go with some, I say, 2 tablespoons of Mojo barbecue and a tablespoon and a half of sriracha. See if we can get a little heat going on inside that butt. Now, use your vessel of choice to mix it up. Just don't close the lid because it can make a mess. Once it's well shook up, strain it. Make sure you get out your big particles. That way you don't stop your injector up. Now, we've got about 14 ounces of liquid in here. Let's try to get it all in this butt. Now, it's going to make a mess. It may get on your shirt. It may get on the walls. Let's try our best to get it all in there. Once we got that injected, it's time for the flavor. And that's the Mojo barbecue. Hey, don't be scared to use a whole bottle. Because I guarantee you, when you run out, I know a guy to sell you some more. So once you get them all rubbed down, let's let them set for about 30 minutes until they look like this. Let's put them out on the smoker. Now, my way of doing this is strange. I'm going to put these butts on at 400 degrees. Now, I'm not going to leave them at 400. What I'm going to do, when I shut this lid, I'm going to check back my vents. And I'm going to finish out this cook at 300 degrees. And I'm going to run 3 hours, not even open the door, and not even look at that butt. And after those 3 hours, this is what you got. Hey. It looks good enough to eat, but it's not tender enough to eat. So we're gonna have to wrap it. Once I fight with this aluminum foil for a few seconds here, I'll show it who's the boss. See, I got it. We're gonna wrap these butts up. We're not gonna put anything in the wrap. We're just gonna let them sit there and baste in their own juices. All right, now we got her wrapped tight. I'm gonna give her a spin, look and see if there's a ghost behind me. Slider, I don't know what I'm doing. All right, we're gonna probe these up because I want to make sure I'm just cooking the temperature on this one. Make you a little hole, that way when you put your probes in, you're not gonna push any foil down into the meat, and set it for 203 degrees. So going back on 2.5 hours later, there we have it. Now I know these butts are tender, so I'm not even gonna double guess myself. What we're gonna do is put them in a cooler. Well, that's not going to fit. Back up and punt. Alrighty, take them off the rack. Well, yep, I got it in there. Let these butts rest for, let's say, an hour. And hey, this is what you've got. Injected butt is on your left. It looks great. And for the true test, you got to pull that bone. And once she comes out clean, that means she's perfect. So we got to get these pulled so I have that taste test. So I got a little help, make this go a little quicker. Man, look at the juiciness in them babies. Alrighty, here's my tip for today. You know you got flavor on the outside of that butt. Always add a little rub and get it on the inside. You want flavor all the way through. We're gonna give them a good little toss and I'm gonna bring in my girls and see what they think. Well, I'm going to toss a little longer than I was talking. So, come on now. Here we go. And, yep, there we go. Now, this is my oldest. Let's see what she thinks. She's tasting the Dr. Pepper. Hey, that's my girl. She likes one with a little heat. Now, the youngest. Once she gets that spaghetti noodle up in her mouth, she picked the traditional pork. Can't blame her. Now for the boss. Boss will tell you how it is. Dadgummit, she likes traditional too. Now for the professional judge. I'm going to get him a mouthful. Man, that's good. Got that mojo flavor. Nice, tender, moist. Let's check out this other bite. Alrighty, that's a big bite. Hey, now this one right here, packed with flavor. Got a little bit of extra. Ooh, what was that? Anyways, got a little extra moisture, a little extra sweetness. And man, that back heat on the end, it makes it. Now you can't go wrong with either. Well, the wife, she's changing her mind here. But you can't go wrong with either one of these butts. And I just wanted to show you that, hey, it's an easy cook. Don't let it intimidate you just because it's a big chunk of meat. Just put it out there, cook it, have fun. And happy Easter from the Mojo Clan. And remember the reason for this holiday. We'll see you soon.